Bo. Hello. Okay, so let's keep going. Been a while. Hey, wait. I already came through here, didn't I? I sure did. Maybe I have to go to a different entrance. Oh, wait, no, I have to backtrack a little bit. That's right. So, I think we have to go back to Bellamy Temple. Here we go north. Yeah, there we go. If we do this fast enough, we can get an item for it. So I'm trying to cheese it a little bit. Oops, overshot it there. We're not trying to do it slow, we're trying to do it fast. No, 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 no. That's not good enough. Hey, there we go. Thank you. Hey, that actually works pretty good. Okay, Bean Valley. Buzzer is about to sound for you. An octopus can fly if it tries. Okay, level up for Peach. Oh, there he goes, he's dancing. Another level up. He learned Ultra Fireball. Mallow as well. And he learned Star Rain. Pucker up for a bruising. I may have already gotten them. All right, where are you hidden? Just Where are you, hidden chest? There you are. Seemed like a very specific spot. I want it to be just a normal flower. Oh. Please no. I waited 100 years for that, and it was worth it. Ginny was inside. At long, long last, I am free. Ow. Oh, we got him. Ooh, a red essence, nice. So these things can use the rude sandstorm. Thank you. Freaking out about what might be in the box? You should be. It's a please no. They never ever stop watching you. It was caught cheating at treasure chest slots and confined inside please no as punishment, where it is being forced to clean. I see. Candy. Nice. Coca-Cola. Okay, let's come back to this one. Coin. All right. Play with me, give me attention! Yeah, that's a dog, all right. Level up for Bowser. Mecha Koopa Stomp, Bowser's ultimate weapon. There we go. That was weird. Okay. So now we have access to Great Guy's Casino. Too bad the bouncers won't let us in without a membership. Alright, I'll be back in a few minutes. I gotta help with something. Sorry about that, I'm back. Okay, so... let's go ahead and equip Peach with the safety badge. Okay, time to take on the next boss. Look away, look away! Okay, I hope I don't have to... well, just in case. Okay, no, it's still the same one. There's the big guy. Got watered and grew quickly. I'll wilt quickly too. That's the life of a flower. Nice. By Mega Smilax. Look what you did, Smilax has been whacked. Oh, I'm going to get it. Queen Valentina told me to keep everyone out of Nimbus Land. I'll run away. Hello? It's a seed. Did you see that? It's a magical beanstalk. Hit the block once more to climb it. Okay, so from here... Just go straight to the big vine. Nice. I hate that Valentina. You got an Energizer. Raises allies' attack power in battle. Oh, that's nice. Climb and circle around vines with the control stick, jump to another vine by tilting and pressing B. Use the shadows below you as your guide. Oh boy, depth perception. Psych Bomb, make me mad, and boom! Big is beautiful. The big guy is ready to launch. I'm missing some entries. They might seem riled up, but they're just playful at heart. They get a bad rap because of their absurdly painful bite. Is it strange to call these Smilaxes when the only time they show their pearly teeth is to bite? It can use Petal Blast even though it isn't the right season for it to bloom. That's what you get from a freak of nature like this. Pretty though. Grinder is their move where they swipe with their spear instead of using their claws. As they say, the early birdie grinds the worm. In their downtime for serving in Bowser's minions, they're in high demand as shell wax models. Double page spreads only, of course. Of course. There we go. Thank you. Mario, my man! What is with your accuracy in this battle? I seem to recall this was a particularly difficult jump to make in the SNES version. That's really stupid. Look at that. Weird, I've done that before in the SNES version without even knowing about that. But that grabbing an invisible... grabbing an invisible part of the vine, that's new to me. Defense scarf. Raises defense power. Is it better than the ghost metal? Oh, that just halves all damage, I think. So it's the ghost scarf was probably better. Got some flowers. See, the loot was worth it. These guys look familiar. Shut up! Oh, good, they found Prince Mallow. There he is, Prince Mallow. Wow, I can't believe she's marrying Prince Mallow and becoming a queen. What a coincidence! The prince has the same name as me! Was Prince Mallow that huge? Oh, this one I remember, I think. Yep, that's an easy one. You have that I'm looking for something look in your eyes. Got a mega glove. Sticky glove. Hand cannon. And war fan. And then fluffy shirt. Fluffy pants. Okay, I think it's finally time to start upgrading his gear. Fluffy dress. Yeah, work pants are actually really good for Gino. Yeah, because Bowser doesn't get anything to the volcano, I think, if I remember correctly. I'll take a break. You want to use this dream cushion to rest? I'll try anything once! This is different. Okay. In the original, didn't he just kind of like float through the air on his pillow? Let's go talk to the sculptor. Hello, Garo. Look at that. Oh, the king when he was young. He's really a prince. Yeah. Do you understand now? The dream mattress dreams are randomized? Oh. Who'd have thought? Well, that didn't work. Oh. We are now Goldio. Could you have picked a better pose than your walking pose, Mario? Oh, there we go. This doesn't look like Valentina at all. Let me keep poking it. Mariota. Okay. Oh, there she is. What is this ugly thing? In search of lost brother. The thick mustache. With it, I depict his kind feelings for his younger brother. The sideburns conveying his strength of heart. The legs, well-defined, strong, legs that can leap any distance at a single bound. Funny because she was just calling it ugly. There he is, the round boy. I mean, it's fitting considering who Valentina is. Uh-oh, Dodo's in a pretty bad mood. Keep up your statue disguise and jump to avoid getting pecked. Get ready, because he's coming. Da 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 Ah, damn it. Easy. Hey, look, I got the feather. Hi. Oh boy, the jig is up. One of those high-tech or lifelike realistic ones. Speed up by 20, wow. Actually better than the Troopa metal? I didn't think that it was better. So it offers the same speed, but it also gives some defense and magic defense. So yeah, at the end of the day, it's actually better. Hear my new song? Oh, right, I've got the punch glove again. Gotta get reused to that. Jump on me. You'll know you're a grown-up when your joints ache like mine. Ow. Our forecast for tomorrow, let's just say bring an umbrella. Next up, traffic. Ah, now this one's pretending to be a statue. Oops. Gotta get used to his new weapon now, too. When they ring their bells and let fly with a doom reverb, it feels to you like the gloves are off, but to them, they're just treating you to a song. They want to heal injured orb users, but they're going through a trial separation right now. Will the orb users and Orbisons ever reunite? They spin the blow air and hinder people walking, but I've heard a rumor on the wind that there's one in a town somewhere blowing pleasant breezes. They may have the same appearance and behavior as Lukos, distinguished only by their color, but they're definitely not filler. That's just how monsters are. Strong enemies who employ powerful magic. Some of them retire, enjoy a second career as shopkeepers. No, I'm really curious, like, where this set of monsters is. Because I'm really not sure. Unless there's a whole area I miss. Oh, the tomato dudes! I got a couple of the clones. So they're a bit further up on the list. Huh? It's Zarp! This thing is actually just Zarp! This is where the other clones go. That would be Peach and that would be Mallow. So I'm not sure. Oh, I know what it is. I know what it is now. I didn't miss something. Yeah. These big eaters are known as the gourmands of the imp world. They love meat dishes, especially hamburgers and hashed beef rice. That sounds good right about now. Well, it was kind of hard to tell on the SNES for a lot of things. Like in Booster's Tower, it was so pixelated that no one could tell it. But in Booster's Tower, on like the first floor, there's actually one of the armors from Final Fantasy VI. Magitek, that's right. I couldn't think of the name. No, it actually was in the original. Hold on, I'll bring it up in just a minute. Okay, here's a good picture. It has both the original and the remake version. Yeah, it's so pixelated in the SNES version that no one could tell that it was Magitek armor. I think with this weapon, right as he's raising his elbow is the right time to hit it. Wow, none of these are good. Even Bowser's HP, yeah, like someone was saying, Bowser's HP is never worth increasing through this. So just go for more attack. You are magnificent. Thank you. Okay, this one may not be- it may be on top of the actual treasure chest, so I may not be able to get this one yet. Syrup. Oh, I wasn't paying attention. That's the first time I screwed that up. Okay, so there's a secret in here. Thank you. That was weird. I didn't hit the button, but it went anyway. Oh well. I've been using... Oop. I've got a flower tab anyway. Alright, so there's that one. Oh, and there's another one. Oh, hey guys! A huge egg in the middle room. It spits out eggs from time to time, and sometimes when you shield yourself, the eggs will ricochet off of you. Ooh! Thank you! A master key? I'll take it. I found Yoster Isle, if that's what you're talking about. Another flower. Egg. Why are you watering an egg? Sorry, dude, you're stuck here with me. Hello? Sure? Thank you. Oh, here it comes. It's Birdo. Oh, well, that was easy. Thank you. Don't forget about me. If you underestimate one, thinking it's no different from a birdie, its powerful ice magic will leave you pale with fear. To understand what they're all about, you need to peek at the thoughts of the person inside, not the suspicious Shelly. The way that she shut herself away inside Shelly may mean that she was patiently pining for the one who'd come break open her shell. Okay. That shy away is still up there. I didn't even know the eggs were actual enemies. Every time I fought Birdo, it's never got a chance to do that. Not fuck up this time. Loads of money. Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. King Nimbus is resting in bed. Absolutely no running in the halls. Wait a sec. It won't open, it's locked. Oops. But what about the door? Hi. Oh. Oh, cool. Another Energizer. Out of my way, big guys. What does a Mario look like? Bushy mustache, long sideburns, and a pair of mean-looking legs. Hello? Isn't a statue, that's Mario. I've heard they took away her jiggle physics in her fight. Everyone in a 10-mile radius could hear you. So long, chumps! Bye, Dodo. Well, I mean, they jiggled when you attacked her. Not that there was actual jiggle physics. That's what I meant to say. Now, there is a power star there. I'm gonna ignore it temporarily, because I know Dodo's here. Yes, I could have power starred him missing, but then I wouldn't have got his tattle entry. That's the point. That was quick. Oh, down we go. Gotta pose. Oof. The reasoning for that Zarp is that I heard Mario, I think Miyamoto said he thought that was too childish of a thing for Mario to do. So I think that's why he does just the hat thing now. Hello, Valentina. Let's get her. Oh my, that's a big woman. Nice martini glass. Oh, well, there goes Bowser. Gotcha, Dodo. Oh, shit. Woo! 2000 HP. He's a small man who puts on a big front. Oh, well, thanks for waking me up. Hey, there you are, Bows.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this is bad. Oh yeah, this is bad. Alright, we got her. Okay, bye, Valentina. And they all just kind of disperse. Oh, there's the key. Nice umbrella. I like that he knew that was coming. There's his parents. The Mario? Jumping Mario? Woohoo! Wahoo! Dreaded Czar Dragon inhabits the volcano. I mean, going back to the SNES version, I ended up just calling her Peach anyway. Because that's just what she's commonly known as now. Thanks, dude. Nice, another flower jar. Hey, look at that. Statues for the whole party. Oh. Ah. There we go. Rocco! You again! An echo signal ring. If you equip it, it'll tell you the locations of hidden treasures. So what's the difference? What's the difference between this and the regular echo signal ring? Oh, reveals the exact locations. Because in the original SNES version, you didn't get the signal ring until this room. So I was wondering how they were gonna handle that. Also, if we head over here, busted. What to do? I'll give you this fertilizer if you let me go. Okay. Bye. Okay, so from here, let's go back to the world map. Let's go back to Rose Town. It's time for Mario to be completely busted. I'll never forget the game, a book about an ornate site. Seeds my imagination changed my life, but it was that one day I would make that plant my own. Try to learn such a risk out lives for it to report my heart into the idea. But if the seed itself, none of it was any use, which is like the seed as a gardener. That's why the love is important to me, why I must insist by any parts you have. Really? Did you get all that? I've seen forever. I thought it was merely a rumor. Search high and low for the world over, but I never claimed those final. Made contact with the Beazle Clan in Bean Valley, but both times my hopes for the world were dashed. Consent formulated myself, that route seemed to be impossible. So I should say, I felt my lifelong dream as a gardener. Really kind of stuff of paramount importance to you handing it. Really? Again, did you get all that? There you go. Wow. You think it can use more fertilizer? Maybe not, huh? The lazy shell? And the lazy shell! Alright, so one's a weapon. Mario's best weapon in the game. The other is armor, which is the best armor in the game. At least defense-wise. Because it lowers your other stats by quite a bit. But it's perfect for Peach, since she doesn't really do that much damage anyway. Knife guy should be back here, I think. It's a little further up, I think. Excuse me, boys. Oh, yeah. Hold on. He imprinted on Valentina when he hatched and thought she was his mother. He was shocked to discover he was secretly Prince of Nimbus Land. He resents Valentina, who's not his real parent, and took it out on some of her statues. But only he can't ignore his debt to her for raising him. She knows enough about food to pronounce pizza in the traditional way. Her favorite candy is those Valentine's message hearts, chalky as they are. Ugh. Could you imagine liking that? Those Valentine heart candies? Oh, there you are, knife guy. I think we gotta do this like 15 or 20 times. There we go. Twelve times? Oh, okay. Well, we got the card. Okay, so now we're at Great Guys Casino. Well, at least we can access it. I'm always just a little bit slow. There we go. Cool. Which card is Geno's? Hey, if you aren't cheating, you aren't trying. Look the other way. So you have to do this. You have to do this, and I think you have to win a hundred. Well, I don't know if you have to win, but you have to do it 100 times. I think you may actually have to win 100 times, but you don't have to do it consecutively. But it gets you a star egg, which is a battle item that you can use infinitely. I don't think that's worth it. So let's go back to mobile. I haven't got the shiny stone yet, right? No. Okay. So we buy fireworks from him. I'd like a shiny stone. And I'll give you fireworks. A pretty stone. A mystery egg. I have no idea what it does. A feather just fell right out from the sky all of a sudden. I may have picked it up off the ground, but it's a real gem. Okay, so he doesn't get the frying pan until after the volcano, I think. The egg is a little weird. It's only for Peach to hold. Oh wait, no, it's not the hold item. She has to use it, but she has to be wearing the nurture ring. Eventually it becomes like a sleepy sheep or something, or like the precursor to the sleepy sheep. Yeah, it had it had a really weird name in the original. It was called the Batub Ring. Like B apostrophe T-U-B. Yeah, that's it. Hot springs, please. Oh man, we're gonna have to use Tattle on all five of the Axem Rangers. That's gonna take some time. Down we go! Hold on, just a moment. I can't believe Mario fell into a volcano and died. Let's go back to... Where was it? Booster Pass? I think it was Booster Pass. Okay, that was it. Looks like I had to use Tattle on him again in the battle against Valentina. Well, for the most part, we've been keeping up with these. Just a couple that I didn't think about. Oh, I have got a lot of frog coins. Oh, before we go to... let's go back to Seaside Town. Let's get the flower ring. Cool. All right, back to the volcano. I like that it has to play that animation each time you go back. That's funny. Alright, let's get Mallow back in the party.
Yeah, yeah.
Hit me to know happiness. Okay. I like that you can actually see its face now. I think in the original, all you could really see is its shell. Come here, you. Rumble, rumble. I mean, it's Mario's ultimate weapon. If you don't want to use it, that's on you. It'd be like not using the frying pan on Peach. Besides, Mario really doesn't get another really good item until the final dungeon. One good deed every day. Early to bed, early to rise, and so on. Besides, this is such an easy game anyway, that does it really matter? It sure is hot in here. I should move. We're gonna have to fight him again, because we gotta use Tattle on him too. Come on, get back up. Get back up. You're an adult. If you think something is tasty, then eat it. Sage advice. matter where I go, I'm unwanted. Ow. Ooh, he dropped pure water. We're at that point where we're really starting to get shitty level ups. Yeah, we're starting to get diminishing returns now. Sensei resemble Magmite in shape and color, and because their names start with the same four letters, they often get each other's mail by mistake. They're jealous of shoguns because their names sound a lot cooler. I've seen a whole lot of monsters, but I still have a really hard time telling the difference between lava babbles and lava bubbles. Those who fled from the village of the gorillas settled at Barrel Volcano. As time passed, they eventually came to be known as Chained Kongs. Is it too much of a stretch to guess that the reason they carry water bottles is to fight the heat stroke caused by the volcano's unbearable temperature? These urchin-like creatures were thought to live only in the sea, but these live in a sea of magma. Ooh, a max mushroom. One HP. Great. Okay, that monster is gone, but that's okay. There'll be another one. I'm pretty sure. Okay, he's got two parts, so we're gonna have to use Tattle twice. Oh, now this one's kind of weird. There we go. I got it. Ooh, that defense. The way this one works is we exit the room. Yeah. There's lava nearby? I couldn't tell. I'm pretty sure it would be less than a minute before you burn up. An explosion of love. Lava boom. Nice miss, pal. They give new meaning to the idea of stomping your feet in frustration. Because they don't touch the ground, they can't stamp along with their feet. It must be a frustrating feeling. Their go-to attack is backfire, but when they're in a tough fight, or fly off the handle, or fall in love, they get agitated and use va-va-voom instead. Another one of these things. That is a big shell. It's called the Lazy Shell. That's a cool looking toad. He's got like Bowser bracelets, he's got a beard, sunglasses, a flame hat. He's got it all, man. Cinder Toad. The Cinder Mart. Wing, Captain Falcon's Racer, and that's Samurai Goros? I think that's Samurai, yeah, Samurai Goros. Blue Falcon, that's right. And I completely forgot Samurai Goros, but yeah, Fire Stingray. Wait, is that specifically an R-Wing from Command? Oh, huh, look at that. I think it's finally time. Alright, so it's time to go deal with the Czar Dragon. The Zarp Dragon. Hey, look! It's a Blargg! Ice, Fear, Poison, and Mute. Ooh, interesting. I'm fired up, seriously. I'm on fire. How about that? Rabble, 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 Crazola Palace. I'm an ordinary rock, but I'm kind of fired up. We did it. Or not. Whoa. He's Zombone now. Jump, lightning, and mute. I'm not as dead as you might have thought. Zombone. We've actually been completely healed. Huh. Stone statues were built in its image to soothe its temper, but the likeness was way off, so in the end they didn't have much of an effect. It looks like a rock, so you might wonder if it could even be considered a monster, but since you can get a peek at its thoughts, it must be one, right? The character designer's reasoning for giving it tattered clothing only after it becomes zombified is because it didn't look like a zombie without it. Eh, true, a little bit. I love some of these descriptions. They're great. Cool statues. Ah, it's a star. It's our sixth one. Hey, look, it's Zarp! Hey, look, it's me! Zarp, please! I mean, they're cool, but they just kind of show up out of nowhere for like 5 to 10 minutes, and then they're gone. They don't have too much of a presence. So we're gonna have to use Tattle on all 5 of these losers. Hey, that actually looks really cool. I think in the SNES version there was the volcano and then it was just kind of a black background. So it didn't look as interesting, but this looks cool. There's the blade. Here we go. Okay, that was kind of cool. Axem Rangers. Okay, so I have a feeling we can't target the... Yeah, we can't target the blade until all the others are defeated. Group pose went off without a hitch. Oh, okay. We gotta take her out quick. Okay, so that's yellow and pink down. Okay, so the blade's finally active now. Why did they always wait to use me? I like how that was all for 17 experience points. They gave less than the Czar Dragon. Oh, that was fun. Now we finally got our star piece. Yeah, they were... they just kind of show up. You beat them up. Alright, one more to go. Six star pieces have finally been collected. Where could the last one be? Though he is the de facto leader of the Axem Rangers, he's so careless that he often flubs his poses, intro speeches, and group formations. He's cool and composed, but like all the Axem Rangers, something about him is a bit pathetic. He got his beloved sunglasses at a dollar store. Oh man, you're not as cool as I thought. Always calm and doesn't sweat the small stuff. The other Axem Ranger thinks he's aloof, but he hasn't bothered to notice. Considers himself the looker of the team, he tires easily, not from being out of shape, but from too much hot yoga. She considers herself the princess of the group. Meeting an actual princess has done nothing to change her mind on this point. Admittedly, its Breaker Beam attack would be cooler if it was called Absolute Breaker of Champions Beam, but we're not getting paid by the word here. Oh, that's pretty good. They had a lot of fun coming up with some of these descriptions for enemies. Let's go back to Moldville. We should be able to buy the frying pan now. Enough iron to be dangerous. And she can turn it into a drying pan, too. Think of a final phrase that will wrap it up. Let your creative juices flow and show me what you got. Pianissimo! What do you got? Alright, I guess we should try and get prepare for to fight Culex. There's really not a whole lot left of the game. Alright, let's go over our equipment. Peach should definitely put on the lazy shell. I'm gonna give you the ghost medal. Mallow, you can have the defense scarf. Basically, Metroid, we've got Culex to fight, and then we go back to Nimbus Land to take the bus, and then we're at Bowser's Castle. Bowser's Castle is the last part of the game, so we're really close to the end. It's been sealed. Look, the shiny stone is reacting! He's still a sprite! Greetings. I am Culex, Dark Knight of Vanda. I have crossed into this dimension to fight for the Dark Mage. You who stand before me, where does your depth come from? Why are you rendered so three-dimensionally? The evil power that gave me life mapped out this flat plane as my form. You are formed from a power unknown to me. I wish to gain the secret of your three-dimensional world. Use the lucky item here? On guard. I am matter. I am antimatter. I can see your past. I can see your future. I consume time. And I will consume you! Oh my god! Well, first, let's go ahead and increase everyone's defense. Whoosh. Thank you. Oh, that's right. Holy shit! Shit. I feel a bit out of place. Flare! Wow. Hmm. Basically, Spook. She's invincible. Because she has the lazy shell equipped. Shit. Thank you. Oh, he actually did a physical attack. That's surprising. All right. God damn you. Get fucked, Culex. That's awesome. I'm glad they still kept the Final Fantasy victory fanfare. Spirit is strong. This legendary strength is the power of that third dimension. It is far mightier than the forces of malevolence could dream. I will treasure this memento of my journey here. Perhaps in another time, another game, we may have been mortal enemies. Someday I will gain the power of this third dimension and those forces will visit a land not yet mapped. Until that time, take this, treasure it as a keepsake of our fight. Farewell, Champion Knight. And his door just disappears. So he gives us... Where is it? Oh, there it is. Shining Source of Power. So is it actually better than the Attack Scarf? It straight up just doubles your attack power, right? Like how the ghost metal just straight up doubles your defense. It applies Geno boost every turn? Oh. Interesting. I'll give it a try. Well, that's a fun fight. There's one hidden treasure left. Wow. I wonder where it is. Alright, well, I've been going for 3 hours now, almost 3.5. We'll finish this up next time. I'm not sure if I'm going to do any of the post-game stuff, because I need to move on to... I need to go back to Crisis Core, and then Final Fantasy VII Remake, so I can hopefully finish that in time before Rebirth comes out. But we'll see. Anyway, I'm done for now.